Hi all, and welcome. Now, this video is not about whether Barack Obama's birth certificate is real or fake. It's not about that, as you will see. Now, in an article by Dan Crosby, he has basically gone and stated that Barack Obama's lawyer admitted forgery of Barack Obama's birth certificate. So, let's have a closer look at this article. I'll put a link to it in the description box. This is more of the article. We will zero in on this part here. This is Alexandra Hill. You will see here in the video I've edited out very soon. So, Obama's lawyer, Alexandra Hill, admitted that the image of Obama's birth certificate was a forgery. I've taken some a bit of the clip out of this part here, which is about an hour long, and about 11 minutes in, I've taken about 2 minutes out of that you're just about to see. Now, Obama's lawyer is not talking about whether or not Barack Obama's birth certificate is real or fake. That is not the issue at hand, as you will see. And further, the notion that she would go and sort of admit that Barack Obama's birth certificate is fake is just ridiculous, really. The other thing that that came to my attention was that there were no quotes in the Tribune article related directly to how she went about saying that Barack Obama's birth certificate was a forgery. It's just ridiculous. So anyway, here is the footage, a little bit of the footage, the pertinent footage, and you can go and see the whole clips for yourself. But this has been getting around. I believe it to be incorrect information, so enjoy.
Yes. I'd like us to draw back to the point of why we are here today, which is the presidential primary ballot. In New Jersey, objections must be based on the statutory requirements for a presidential petition under NJSA 19 and specify in detail each individual defect. The challenge can only be based upon the criteria for a presidential primary petition under New Jersey law. The qualifications for a presidential primary candidate in New Jersey are as follows. Must be signed by at least 1,000 voters throughout the entire state. Candidate's name and address must appear on each petition. The circulator witness is the person who collected the signatures on the petition and must complete and sign the affidavit where indicated. Circular must sign the petition as petitioner on a numbered line and location of signature must be identified.
Just for the record, where are you voting from? NJSA
1925-3, 1923-7, 1923-11. Even if petitioners did have an authentic copy of Obama's birth certificate, there is no requirement under New Jersey law that the candidate for president publish, produce, or release an official birth certificate. The claim is not relevant to the presidential primary ballot. In fact, under New Jersey law 1925-3, it is not required to have the consent of the person who is running for the presidential primary endorse the petition.
So somebody could be running around with a petition to put you on the ballot and could get 1,000 signatures, and if you met everything else on there, you'd be on the ballot whether you wanted to be or not.
Yep.
That's what you said.
100%.
So basically, in regards to the presidential primary ballot in New Jersey, the person the petitioners are petitioning to get on the ballot has no obligation to produce their birth certificate. I'll leave you now with a smaller part of that clip where some seem to think that Obama's lawyer, Alexander Hill, actually said that Obama's birth certificate is a fake, which is ridiculous.
Even if petitioners did have an authentic copy of Obama's birth certificate, there is no requirement under New Jersey law that the candidate for president publish, produce, or release an official birth certificate. The claim is not relevant to the presidential primary ballot.
So as a thought experiment, let's just pretend for a minute that Barack Obama's lawyer, Alexandra Hill, did just admit that Barack Obama's birth certificate is a fake. Do you not think that there would be some sort of utterance from someone around the courtroom if she actually said this. As you have noticed, there was no utterance because there was no admission. It's just a ridiculous claim. Bye for now.